Hello everyone. In this session, I am going to explain the interview question. What is the purpose of using packages in Java? So what is the purpose of using packages in Java? So to straightforwardly answer this particular question, you can start by mentioning that packages in Java are used to group or organize the related classes, interfaces, and other files together. Okay. So what are packages? Packages in Java are used to group, okay, group or organize the related, okay, packages are going to group or organize the related classes, interfaces, and any other files together under a single branch, right? So these are nothing but packages. This is a very straightforward answer for the question, guys, but to add more value to your answer, okay, you can mention all these points, okay, which will prove your knowledge on the packages. Packages basically in Java are useful to group or organize the related stuff, okay, related classes, interfaces, and any other files under a single window, okay, that is known as packages, under single section, that's known as packages. Now the following are the different benefits that you get on using packages in Java. Okay, if you mention these benefits as part of your answer, that will add a lot of value to your answer and interviewer will get good confidence on your answer, guys. So let's explore all these benefits of packages in Java. First benefit is to bundle. We already covered it, grouping the related classes, interfaces, and other files. Okay, that is nothing but bundle. Okay, using packages, we can bundle a group of related classes, interfaces, or other files. Okay, you can bundle them. Okay, you can club them and then give it for other use also. Okay, you can also share with other teams if you feel that your packages has good content. Okay, they may become popular also. You can bundle them and share with other teams. Okay, other groups over the internet. So, and the second benefit is, it's a good practice to group the related classes and interfaces and other files using packages, guys. Why we have to group the related things then? Okay, why we have to group or organize the stuffs in our projects is because it will be easy to find and maintain the related stuff later. Okay, later when you come and see the project, okay, it should not be a zigzag, right? Zigzag thing should not be there. It should be a well organized project. Okay, it should be well organized project where all the related stuff are together, so that it will be easy for the other people to find out, other people or you at a later point of time, to find out the related stuff at different sections. Okay, at different sections, package will do that job. Okay, and when you easily find this stuff together, you can easily maintain that, right? If you have to do some changes in one of the file, okay, at later point of time, if you come to the project and see if you are not able to find, that is a problem, right? But with packages, all these files will become organized, okay, will be organized in such a way that you can easily find them, and also it will be very easy to maintain them, okay, right, as you can easily find them later. Fine, that is the second advantage. Okay, one thing is, first advantage is bundling. Okay, you can bundle them together, okay, for other purposes. You can find them easily, okay, if they are organized or grouped together, you can find and maintain them easily later point of time if you group them together using packages. Third thing is to prevent naming conflicts. Okay, to prevent naming conflicts. Let me explain that concept here. For example, I will create a new package here. New package. I will name this package as package A. Okay, finish. Then under this, I will create a new class known as some class A. Okay, finish. And under the same package, again, I will create a new class. I will try to give the same name. You see, Java is not allowing me to click on finish because this class A already exists. Okay, this class A already exists. What if I create a new package, say package B, and under the package B, I will create the same class, class A. Now you see the naming conflict is not happening. Okay, even though inside the same project you have the same class names, class A. Okay, just because of they being in different packages, Java is avoiding the naming conflicts. If you want to create good number of classes with the same name, then you have to separate them under different packages. Then only you can create this. You cannot create the classes having the same name under a single package. You have to distribute them across multiple packages so that the naming conflicts will be resolved by these packages. That is another advantage of the packages. The last and final advantage of the packages is packages provide access protection. Okay, access protection. So this access protection I can easily explain with help of this modifiers, guys. Access modifiers. There are some access modifiers in Java like public, private, protected, and default. Okay, these are the four access modifiers in Java which are very much related to these packages. Okay, so let me explain this stuff here. Classes, variables, and methods which are specified with public access modifier. Okay, let's say here we have this public. This is a public access modifier. This is declared before the class. Okay, this is a public access modifier. If you specify such kind of public access modifier before classes, variables, and methods, okay, this classes, variables, methods can be accessed by the classes inside the package and also outside the package. But for outside the package, if you want to access these classes, variables, and methods, you need to import those classes. Okay, what I mean to say here is I will demonstrate that to you. Okay, so let's say I will create one more package. See, package C. Okay, under this package I'll create a new class known as class C. Okay, class C, finish. Now guys, I'm in a different package. Now I want to access this class A, and I will rename it to class B now. Refactor rename. Okay, sorry. Right click, refactor or rename. I'll just rename it to class B now. Okay, for this example. So now we have three different classes under three different packages. Okay, it's taking time. Okay, it got renamed. Fine. Now let's say, now we have three classes under different packages, right? Class A under package A, class B under package B, class C under package C. Now let me create one more class here, that is class X. Okay, class X. Now guys, inside class X, if I want to access class A, okay, inside class X, if I want to access class A, let me create a main method, public static void main string of args. Okay, string array of args. Now here inside this class X, from this main method, if I'm trying to access this class A which is inside the same package, class X and class A are inside the same package, that is package A. Okay, now I'm trying to access the class A. Class A, A is equal to new class A. So in this case, you will not get any error. You can directly use it. Okay, You can directly use a class A. Use a class A is directly possible because class A is of which type? Public type. Okay, public type. Class A is public type. Hence, you can directly use it inside the same package. What about in a different package? Let's say I will open class B here. Okay, I will open class, otherwise class X here. Okay, I will open the same class X here. I was able to use class A because class A is inside the same package and it is of public type. And class B is also public type, right? Class B is also public type, but it is in a different package. Class A is in the same package of the class X, but class B is in a different package of class X. But class B is public. What happens if I create an object for the class B? Class B, B is equal to new class B. Okay. What will happen here is class B, you are getting a kind of error kind of thing. When you hover the mouse, it will ask you to import. Why you have to import this? Okay, because this class B belongs to a different package. Since it is a public type, it is allowing you to import. Okay, when you import, it will work. The first statement here mentions the same thing. Classes, variables, methods which are specified with public access modifier can be accessed by the classes outside the package only after importing the classes. This is access protection. Okay, this is how the packages are protecting your classes. In order to access a class B which is in a different package, you need to import the package. Okay, class, import that class from the different package, then only you are allowed to use it. Okay, but if it is in the same class, you can use it because it's of public type. Even of class B of public type, you can only use class B in a different package only after importing it from a different package. Okay, that's the first level of access protection provided by the packages. Now let's move to the next one, that is default. Okay, default means public to all the classes inside the same package and private to the classes which are outside the package. What if for the class C, I'll remove the public. Okay, I'll make it normal class. Okay, public is not there. If I am not providing public or private here, this will become, okay, this will public, private or protected here. This will become a default class. Okay, default access modifier is applied there. Now, again, in the class X, if I try to access class C, what will happen? Let's see. Class C is equal to new class. Class C is equal to new class C. Okay. So this is a default access modifier specified class and which is outside the package. So what will happen? You cannot get even import also, because this statement clearly states that default means public to all the classes inside the same package and private to all the classes outside the package. That means private means you cannot access, guys. There is no way that you can access it. This is not possible at all. Okay. Java packages are completely protecting this default access specified class outside the packages. Okay. Inside the package, you can do that. For example, if I create the, let's say I will create some class Y here inside the same package, and I remove this public. Okay, remove the public. Now, from the class X, if I try to create an object for the class Y, what will happen? Let's see. Class Y, Y is equal to new class Y. It will allow you, guys. Okay, it will allow you because class Y is inside the same package. But even the class Y has default access modifier only, and class C also has default access modifier. But class C is outside the package, class Y is inside the package. That's why it's allowing inside the package. So class Y will become public inside the package and private outside the package. That's why you cannot access class C. Now the last access protection mechanism for the packages, that is for protected access modifier. Okay. Protected access modifier cannot be applied to classes in Java, guys. They can only be applied to variables and methods. So protected variables and methods are public to all the classes inside the same package and private to all the classes which are outside the package except child classes. What do I mean by that? Okay. So for example, if I create some class here, in class package C, the name of the class is class Z. Okay, the public type, not a problem. Inside this, I will create some variables. Okay, I will create some variables. So variables are protected x is equal to some 5. Okay, this is the thing. What is that? Protected int x is equal to y. Okay, sorry. Now this is a protected type. Variable is of protected type. Now from class X, if I try to access this class Z which is of public, I can do that after importing. So I will say, first say class Z, Z is equal to new class Z. Okay, I can import and use it because class Z is of which type? Public type. But the variable which is inside this class Z is which type? Protected. Now if I try to access that Z dot X, I cannot do that, guys, because this X is private outside the package, but inside the package it is public. Okay, for example, here if I say class N, and if I have this public static void main string of args, here if I try to access this I'll try to create object for the class Z. Z is equal to new class Z. If I say Z dot X, you see it's accessible here because this class N is inside the same package. That's why it's accessible. Outside the package, it's not accessible. Like that, guys, packages will provide different types of restrictions for different access modifiers in Java. Okay. Different type of restrictions for different access modifiers in Java. So these are the different things that you can mention, guys. Don't worry. I have given a lot of things for you to explain as part of the interviewer's question, but it's up to you to decide. Whatever you remember, you can mention. Okay. Whatever extent you can remember about these packages, you can mention the same to the interviewer, guys. Okay. It will to add more value, you can mention more. Okay. So that's it, guys. Thank you. Bye.